iMovie can import from cameras that shoot to tape, memory card, hard drive, and DVD. In this video tutorial, I'm going to show you how to import footage into iMovie from a tape-based video camera. First thing I'll do is open iMovie. I'll go to the dock and click on its icon, which is this star. Click once. Once iMovie is open, the next thing I'm going to do is connect my video camera to my MacBook Pro laptop. Now, the two devices that I'm using require a FireWire that has a 4-pin end for the video camera and a 9-pin end for the MacBook Pro. This is something you're going to want to check into depending on the video camera that you're using and the Macintosh computer that you're using. After I have those two devices connected, I'm going to turn my video camera on to the playback mode. Now, once I've done that, iMovie should automatically recognize that I've turned on a video camera, and it's smart enough to know that, hey, you want to import some footage. If this window doesn't appear for you, simply go up to File and Import from Camera, and then you'll receive the same window. Okay, some things to discuss here in this window. First of all, if I leave it set to automatic and go ahead and click import, what will happen is it will rewind the tape in my video camera and import all the footage that's there and then stop. Now, on this particular example, I have just a few seconds worth of footage that I want to import. So I'm going to go ahead and change that to manual. And we can also see here that it's recognizing my camera. This is the type of Canon camera that I have connected. It's also telling me that my footage I shot was standard because it's just DV. Some other things that you see here. These buttons control the tape within the camera, so I can cue the tape up to the exact moment I'd like to start importing. A couple counters I need to tell you about. This counter right here is the key one. As this ticks, this indicates that you're importing footage. The second counter that you see up here, this indicates tape movement within the camera. Now you can have tape movement without import. So it's very important that both are counting. This means that import is happening. The next two buttons here are important. This will take us to the next step of import. I'll go ahead and click it now, which asks us, where do you want to store this footage that I'm about ready to receive? Well, the hard drive can be identified right here. If you're working on your own Macintosh computer, obviously the hard drive of that computer will be fine. Now, if you're a student at Eastern and you're working in the Gregg Technology Center, it's very, very important that you click this drop-down arrow right here and choose a drive that you don't see on my computer because it's not available, but it's called Workspace. And putting everything to Workspace will save it. In our lab environment, we have to set our computers to where every time they're restarted, they erase the hard drive. So any footage that you put on the hard drive in the Gregg Technology Center, the next time the computer's restarted, you will lose it. So very key, if you're working in the Gregg Technology Center, to put that footage on the Workspace drive. Okay, next, you have a couple options here. You can either create a new event, or you can add to an existing event. First time I'm importing footage, I'm going to create a new event and I'm going to name it. I'm going to name it Test Import. You can split days into new events. Your video camera is smart enough to know what days you recorded what footage. So if you're recording footage over multiple days and you want to put everything in one event, you need to uncheck this. Stabilization. Really cool tool, but it adds to the import time, and you can perform stabilization after you have the clips inside of iMovie. So I'm going to choose not to do that right now. Okay, I'm going to click import. I had my video camera queued up to the exact point that I wanted to start importing. Import is in real time. So if you have 20 minutes of video, it will take you 20 minutes to import. Okay, 20 seconds I think is about good enough. I'll go ahead and click stop. Now, What it's asking us is, do you have any more footage that you'd like to import, or are you done? So I'm truly done, and I'm going to click done. All right, and here's what we see. Here we have our footage. The break in between just means that I stopped the video camera and started it again. And you can see over here in the event library, by date and on the hard drive, there's my event that I created, test import. Again, if I wasn't getting this footage on the right drive, I could take this and drag it down to a different drive that was available. So if you're in the Gregg Technology Center, make sure that you have your event on the workspace drive. And that's how you import footage.